So Einstein's work lives on in Italy, but it's hard now to encourage a new generation to take up physics, or is it? With me now is Professor Fernando Quevedo, Director of the International Centre for Theoretical Physics. It is his job to promote studying physics around the world, with a particular focus on developing countries as well. Professor, good to have you with us. Before we talk about how you inspire young people in physics, let's reflect a bit on Rebecca's report. There is this theory that's 100 years old. It's being proved or disproved there in Italy. If it is proven, though, how will it change the way that we see the universe? Why does it matter?
Well, it matters a lot. Well, the gravitational waves is just one of the ways that people have been testing general relativity. Because there are many other ways that people have done it. And, you know, through since the beginning of after 2 or 3 years after Einstein's theory, people came out with the proposals to check it and to test it. And it was it passed the test. Now there are many other tests, and people are using it. When you see a GPS, for instance, they are using general relativity. So in this sense, the gravitational waves is just another test of the theory. And it will teach us a lot about the theory itself, but also about the universe, because we can see some events that can will be very dramatic, that can generate gravitational waves, and that will be a way to understand them better.
With young people today, what is the best way to inspire them? Is it to get something like the GPS and say, this is why we need to understand gravitational waves? No?
No, very good. So I think people usually emphasize those aspects, the apply aspects, because that's what the adults usually see. You know, you need to solve one particular problem and you want to have that concrete application. But remember that the scientists, they start as young kids and young students and researchers, and that's the point, the moment when they get motivated to do science. And then they get fascinated by this kind of things, by Einstein's ideas and by the Big Bang, by black holes, all these very special events, things that motivate people just for the sense of wonder, to understand nature better. And then after that, they can choose a career in science and they can find applications. But the important thing is to find to understand better our universe and our place in it.
But that sense of wonder, I can imagine children, it doesn't matter where they are in the world,
yes,
feel and experience that.
Exactly.
But what about the teaching of physics and the teaching of science? There must be a huge difference depending on where you are.
Yeah, that's a big problem, I have to say. I think worldwide, there's a problem with that, with the level of teaching science in particular for young students in schools. Develop and developing countries. Of course, it's more dramatic in developing countries, and that's our mission is to try to improve science there. But at the level of high school, for instance, or even lower, to motivate students in science is more difficult if they don't have a good teachers. And there are very few countries that actually emphasize and put the teachers in the level of the society that they deserve. And many countries don't treat them, don't provide enough incentives for them to develop as professionals.
I can imagine it was difficult for you in Guatemala, but times have changed since. I mean, the internet must have helped, surely, in the classroom.
Yeah, that's a very good point. Yes, yes, as you say, I'm from Guatemala. And for me to end up now as a professor in Cambridge and now the director of this International Center of Theoretical Physics has been a big step, and I thank all the people who helped me to do it. Now things have changed, but still the conditions are very poor in developing countries. But the countries have evolved. The developing countries, but we usually call developing countries, there's a big mismatch. You see countries like China, Brazil, and India. It's completely different from sub-Saharan African countries or from the small countries in Latin America.
Before I let you go, I just have to ask you, what do you think is the next sort of Einstein moment, the next big thing in physics?
We have been thinking about it for many years. There's a real problem. You have to, in physics or in science in general, you have to identify the questions. What are the important questions? And here there's a well-defined question, and the question is, even though we have the greatest minds in history, Einstein and Newton, gravity is the interaction that we do not understand. And understand it at a microscopic level is the big challenge. So once we have a theory that performs that can explain gravity at a microscopic level, that will be a big success in science.
All these years later, it's still about gravity. Professor, thank you very much for
thank
joining
you.
Us. If you're still a little bit confused about what exactly Einstein's theories are, why they're just so important too, there's lots more on our website. Go to bbc.com/news. We're looking at it all day today on the website.